Welcome to Cotton Buds Florist Christmas Wreath Making Session. Thank you for ordering your kit with us. Before we start, we're going to run through the items that you've got in your kit. First of all, you should have your moss ring and your binding wire, your ribbon, selection of pine cones, some cinnamon sticks, some dried fruits, berries, and your spruce. The first thing that we're going to do is start adding the spruce to your moss ring. You should have your binding wire that is attached to your ring, and I've just added some string so that it's all ready to hang up on the door. Okay, so your spruce has come in long stems like this one, and you just need to, before you start, cut off pieces that you need. Okay, so on your spruce you've got fingers like this. I call them little hands, a sort of hand size. And what we're going to do is trim them off of your stems so that you've got a selection to use before you start. I've already got some here that I've cut off. Okay, so you're going to lay them around your moss ring and you're going to go round all the same way. We're not turning it, we're going to keep it going all the way round so that it gives a flow all the way around your moss ring. And I'm going to select a few pieces to lay onto the ring. So I'll just lay them on and place them where I think they look happy, a couple at a time, and then with my binding wire I'm just going to wrap round a couple of times, give it a tug. That's the first piece on. If you make a mistake, you're not happy how it looks, you can obviously go back and unwind the wire and move your pieces till you're happy. You keep selecting pieces from your spruce, laying them on, just overlapping a little bit to the one before. Again, wrap round with the binding wire a couple of times. Give it a tug. Get your next pieces. Lay it on. Just overlapping a little bit each time. Round a couple of times. If you've got in your garden different types of foliage that you want to use, you can add them in between as you go along. So for example, you might have some ivy or conifer. And if you want to, you need to add them around as you're adding your spruce symmetrically through. So you lay a piece of your different foliage with some spruce right into your ring. Again, just again, wrap it round twice, nice and tight, and then continue with your spruce. Like so, and so that keeps continuing throughout your design. I'm going to take those out because we're just going to keep to the standard spruce wreath. That's just to show you how you can add in different types of foliage for different texture into your wreath. Okay, so my next piece is on. Wrap it round twice. So continue doing this till all of our wreath is covered in the spruce. Nice tight tug so it's in place. On your spruce, sometimes you just get one single piece of growth, like these for example. You can still cut those off and use those, and you can join them together to make a little bundle as well as you go around. And you can use everything off of there, so you should just be left with a stick of spruce which you've cut all the pieces off. Okay, so keep going around, all facing the same way, so you've got some rhythm going around your wreath. Okay, so keep adding your pieces on, overlapping. One, two, give it a tug. You can see it looks a bit gappy here, so the next one I'm going to place to the side there. Another one over the top. And again. Nearly halfway round now, next piece. Lay it on.
one. And twice. See, it's making a nice rhythm of foliage going around the leaf like that.
Okay, so continue placing the spruce all the way around your wreath until you get to the end, and then we'll rejoin again and I'll show you how to cut off your wire ready to put your decorations on. So if we pause for now, and I'll see you soon. Okay, so you should nearly finished your wreath ring now. I'm going to show you how we tie off the binding wire and put the last piece in. Okay, so we're coming towards the top, the last bit of spruce, just tuck the last bit in underneath the first one that we put on. And then with the binding wire we go around twice again.
Okay, so we've put our binding wire on twice, round twice. We're going to cut that off now, so I'll just leave a loop, tuck it round again. Then with the reel, I pass that through the loop and pull, just to finish that piece off. Just turn it round. Okay, so that's nice and secure. I'm going to cut it off. And with this last little piece that's hanging, I'm going to tuck it into the wreath ring. Let's get that a little bit shorter. Tuck that into the wreath ring there, into the side of it, and just check there's no wire or anything sticking out that could scratch your front door, because on New Year's Day you don't want to take your wreath off and there's scratches all over your door. So any wiring that you do, always check that and tuck the wires into the centre ring or to the outer edge so that there's nothing sticking out on the back. Okay, so there is your finished ring with the spruce all attached. And now we're ready to start putting your decorations on.
Okay, so have a look at your ring and see which part you want to be the top. I've obviously put my twine on ready for the top. Just see how it sits. And now before I start wiring any of my decorations on, I'm going to place things on first to see what I'd like to do. Now you can do yours just exactly how you want. They're all unique. It's your own creation. Some people like everything just at the bottom. Some people just do a third. I'm going to place them around the ring. I'm trying to make it look as naturally as I can. The pine cones, you may have different sizes of pine cones, and just think about the weight of them and put the bigger ones towards the bottom of the wreath ring and the smaller ones towards the top, and it just balances it out on your front door. Otherwise it can look too top heavy. And I'm going to put them where I think they might sit naturally in the ring before I start wiring them on. Again, I tend to put my pine cones all facing the same way round so that it follows the flow of the pattern of the wreath. Okay, so I might tuck those in like that. Again, the points are all going around the same way. You don't have to, but that's just me. I like to put them naturally like this. Just tuck them in between the spruce leaves. So I'm happy with my placement of those, and so I'm now going to show you how you wire them into your ring.
Okay, so that's how I've placed mine at the moment. Just laid them on to check that I'm happy before I wire them in. Okay, you don't have to do them symmetrical. Another thing that florists say when you're
at college is not to do anything in fours. If I place just four pine cones on in a four, like that, it loses the circular shape, it makes it look blocky, it makes a square, and we want it to look flowy with a rhythm going around the leaf. So it's normally threes or fives or sixes when you place things around a wreath. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how you wire your pieces into your wreath. All your pieces should already be wired. You just tuck your pine cone in where you want it to sit, lifting up the spruce. I've separated the wire apart because you're going to tie that around your moss ring. Okay, so find a little space, tuck it between the leaves. Turn it over. I'm just going to twist the wire several times. And if they're too long, you can snip them off and then tuck them into the inner side of the moss ring. Okay, so that's the first pine cone on. So I'm going to put my next one in here. Just split the wire. So I've got two legs like the splits. Tuck that in so it looks natural into the foliage. Separate it around the leaves. You can always twist them a bit because they're on a wire once you've turned it back over again. Twist the wire. Tuck it in. My second pine cone on. I'll just repeat that. Okay, so I've finished putting my pine cones on now. Every little while I do lift up the wreath just to see how they're sitting. And because they are wide, you can twist them and move them to sit different ways if you're not too happy. Okay, so now you can enjoy putting on all your other little bits and pieces. If you've got anything particular out of your own, please feel free to do that. You've got your binding wire left, so if you wanted to wire any baubles or anything of different colours, then you can put those in. I'm going to carry on putting the fruits in. Just one thing with the fruits, I tend to tuck it some of them towards the edge, so that from the side you've still got some decoration to look at, and some towards the centre, just to balance the rhythm of it going around the wreath again. I do quite like symmetrical things. I know some people are different to me, so it's entirely up to you how you place your pieces, but we'll come back together when we've finished our wreath and then I'll show you how to complete with the ribbon. Another thing you can add at this point, if you've got lots of ivy in your garden, or you know neighbours, or if you go on walks and you see ivy, if you wanted to add ivy in at this point, you can do. Just thread it around your wreath and place it how you'd like it. This isn't quite long enough, but that doesn't really matter. You'll just cut a piece of your wire off and wire it in just the same, a few points around the stem. So I'll just wire that on there. I'm not going to keep this on mine, but I've just put this on to show you what you can do. Twist the same as you did the pine cones, just to anchor it into the ring. Behind that cone. Just fix it onto the ring like that. Twist it. Tuck your wire in. And you've got some ivy through it. Obviously that's optional. The creation's your own, so you can add and take off things whatever pleases you. Okay, so now you should have added all your decorations to your Christmas wreath. And the last thing to put on is your ribbon. Some people don't like to put ribbons on. Some people like the ribbons at the bottom, some at the top. Some like them with a longer end to them so they can twist it through. Again, it's your choice, it's your wreath. They're all individual. I'm going to have mine to the top. I'm just going to show you how we tie that on. Make sure you put it centrally. Again, it's just the same as wiring all the decorations on. It's split your wire. I've just wrapped some of the binding wire around the bibbon. Stick it into the top. Twist the back. Tuck the ends on the sides. Make sure it's sitting nicely. Okay, so once your ribbon's on, that's your wreath finished and ready for your front door. Hope you've enjoyed making that and adding your own little touches to your wreaths. To keep your wreath looking fresh and into the new year, and we do recommend that you give it a little water spritz a couple of times a week, just to keep the spruce looking fresh. It's obviously not in water, and spruce lasts quite a long time, but just to stop it drying out, just give it a good spritz through. And Merry Christmas.